this is not a scripted show. This is not fiction. It's not exactly fact either. So much of our experience is guessing, mind reading, and estimating others. I cannot fathom my son's current depths. I can, however, empathize and not give in to his persuasion and lies. Nope. The days he's been hibernating zombie-like in my house are uncountable. One weekend and a few days, he's talking very little, sleeping most of the time, isolating in his AirPods, wandering the house at all hours, leaving the lights off this time, as he does not want to be found or seen. I get it. I have been there. It is hard watching your kids suffer. The same shit I suffered. The same journey I started in my teens, he's starting in his 20s. He is adrift. I am lighting signal fires all around him. You could go here. You could do this. What do you want to do? I don't know. Well, he says he knows what he wants to do. He's just not making any moves to get there. It's up to him. When you try for the reach around with one of your children, you get resentment, backlash, and in my case, absolute defiance. As his dad, I suggest one thing. I can be assured he's going to go 180 degrees in the other direction. Here's a program. If you complete recovery, you can come live with me. Fail. He left a week early. His caseworker, who spoke to me the day after he walked out of recovery, said he was defiant from the beginning, wasn't participating, missed appointments. In other words, my son was holding his breath for 30 days in recovery. He made 21 before he bolted. And how he actually got to my house, I still don't know. We live 2 hours at 90 miles an hour away from the recovery center. I'm glad he felt safe coming here. He lied to his caseworker about his plans. My dad said I could live with him. He doesn't want to live with either of his parents. Duh. But he's also not able to make the adult requirements of employment, sleep schedule, and adhering to the plan. Today, at this moment, he does not have a plan. He articulates no ideas about his future. He complains like he's a victim.
I have no car.
Right, about that.
I was in rehab for a month.
Yeah, again, in and doing are two different things. He's defiant. He's looking for my med bag. He knows I have some sleep meds and an anti-anxiety med that he imagines would give him some relief from his sober living bullshit. Yesterday, I was finally able to get him up to go to lunch with me. As we were moving stuff from the car, he noticed my med bag. About 10 minutes after we got home, he said, I'm going to go get a haircut. Can I borrow your car? Sure, with one parameter. 1 hour, no off-map escapes.
Okay.
Let me just get some stuff and I'll give you the keys. I moved the med bag and handed him the keys. Of course, he pushed the limit and was gone an hour and a half. When he got back, he was hopping mad. He never said a word. Didn't say why he was mad. Sulked the rest of the evening as I tried to entice him to watch a movie or a concert video with me. No, just nothing. More zombie walk with the halo of you bastard. I'm not sure what he is thinking. He's doing everything he can to avoid accepting his current situation. I want to say, these wounds are self-inflicted. I don't. He knows. He still complains about no car, as if he's entitled to a nice car, a place to live, and hey, if he can just finish his college degree, a nice place to live, not with either of his parents. Except, that's all he's got left.